Hi leaders, this is Utkarsh Rai and today I am going to talk about candidates accepted the offer but did not join. 4 tips to improve joining ratio for all career levels. Whether you are a CXO or a first line manager, you spend months to hire a right candidate. When they finally accept the offer, you feel elated. This mood changes into anger and frustration when they do not join. As per Glassdoor survey, 18% workers do not accept the offer, and this figure can go up to 40% depending upon the type of profession. Your first blame goes to company's compensation policy, but as per Zeti.com, only 30% of offers are rejected based on compensation. So what about the rest 70%? It is totally in your control. I have recruited thousands of professionals, and my most challenging assignment was when I was setting up an R&D center in India for a California-based early-stage startup. The company was unbranded, operating in an unheard domain where not a single line of code was written then. I only had a few US press releases and the photo of prominent Indian-American Vinod Khosla, one of our angel investors, to share and convince candidates. It was a Herculean task, and we had a very high joining ratio even for first 100 employees. I set up a culture where leaders are responsible for the full hiring process with the support of HR. Blaming HR and recruiters was a strict no. So watch my video until end, where I am going to share 4 tips to improve joining ratio. And if you have not already liked and subscribed to my channel, then please do it. And also watch my other video, Struggling to Retain Employees, Adopt Strategies and Avoid Mistakes. First tip, sense of pride in clearing interview. A. Set up high bar in the interview process. As per Glassdoor survey, the chances of joining improves when candidates face relatively difficult interview process. The chances improves further when they were subjected to skill-based questions rather than personality and IQ ones. Candidates feel differentiated and elated when they clear such interview process. B. Shorter duration with pleasant experiences. Longer interview process, no update or communication between two interviews, and frequent rescheduling of interviews are a big no. Ask interviewers to prioritize interview over other commitment and treat candidates the way they want to be treated. Eric Adelson, Fireplace CEO, says, "What we like to hear at the end of our process that the new candidates are saying, you guys are awesome, everyone is helpful and friendly. We got answer to all our questions and I'm excited to sign the paper." That's the ultimate goal. Second tip, offer them a future, not just a job. Once a candidate takes the job offer, they started to see future in their new company. So sell them your company's brand and vision, just like candidates sell their skills. Talk about company's plan and growth strategies, which are non-confidential in nature, and share exciting press releases. This will help them to see their own professional development in the new company. Also share preparatory reading material for the project, which are available in public domain. Such gestures of frequent sharing will excite them and they will look forward to join the new company. Third tip, help overcome vacillation. Once they accept the offer, they go into confusion period. Current employer, friends, family members' questions might seed some doubt. You should be proactive in clearing such doubts, and if they hesitate, proactively answer some of the common doubts. A. You should answer with honesty. Once I informed a prospective candidate that we are running short of cash after 3 months, but we are confident that the company is going to raise another round of funding. In the worst case, it would be easier for him to get another job, but it would be difficult for me. Such honesty prompted him to join the company and he worked with me for 7 years. B. Rope in others. Just like candidates are getting confused from various quarters, you should also rope in other team members and leaders to talk to the candidate. Same message from various sources does carry weight and does wonders. Fourth tip, persuade but do not push. There is a delicate line between gentle prodding and putting pressure. In spite of your frequent communication to remove doubts, share good points and excite them about future, some candidates do want more time. Give them more time and wait patiently, but keep the communication channel open at less frequency to avoid irritation. Use various communication tools as per the situation to make them feel aware that you care about them and you are waiting for them to join. Some leaders frown about the lack of time. As we are already stressed in order to conduct interviews to close positions and also to manage project, now you are asking us to track candidates even after they accept the offer. Why can't HR or recruiters do it? They can help you, but as said earlier, the complete hiring process till the candidate joins the company should be owned by leaders, because leaders are best placed to convince and influence. Look at the brighter side too. You are already building a bonding with the prospective employee, which will smoothen the induction process and the candidate will become productive fast. If they still do not join, do not take it personally. I have a few candidates who took our offer and did not join at that time. They reached out to me a year later and we hired them because we were still ramping up. Some other candidates who did not join us but referred others because they liked the overall experience. So leaders, undertake these 4 tips, which is totally under your control, and improve the joining ratio. I hope you like this video. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.